My name's Geraldine Curran and I am a nutritional consultant known as the Food Nutritionist, and what I do is take people from ill health to good health. You wouldn't drive around in your car without any petrol. You service your car once a year, yet sometimes we forget about ourselves. Maybe, you know, that the talk is that we're too busy looking after our families, but surely we should be looking after ourselves for our families. It's so important to me, and that's really where I'm at and really where I'm going. I was very, very keen after I had my children, my three sons, to actually make sure that I kept myself quite healthy, even though it's quite difficult having a family and children as well. But the overriding thing was when one of my sons bit into a chocolate biscuit and went into anaphylactic shock when he was four. We had to get him into resus. We only just about got him to hospital. Actually, that's the first realisation that I had, that while exercise is important, it's the food we eat that actually is the real power machine behind every single one of us. I think that the war was actually one of the best times for us for eating foods, even though people don't realise it. We had that grow your own, so we were all out there growing our own food, and literally that's what you had to do. So there was rationing on, there was no sugar. You know, you didn't get any cakes because there wasn't any sort of marzipan or anything like that, because that was all imported, so we didn't have it. But today we've got with the fast food industry, and the world is a canteen. I mean, you can pretty much go anywhere any time of the day and eat something. Things have changed a lot, which is why it's really good to have nutritionists coming forwards in this industry that are really educated. We're not brown rice and sandals brigades anymore. We're really educated. We know what we're talking about, and we're moving forwards and making positive strides. And I remember somebody asking me, you know, how can you be studying food for 5 years? And it's like, you know, I don't think people get it, that's how important it is, and we need to study it to understand it. We take it as a given that the advice that we're given is correct, but actually it isn't. And I think for most members of the public, it's very confusing. The advice that's out there is so, so confusing. And I think the thing is looking at is the hygiene aspect, that we've really gone into overload with this hygiene aspect. And actually, bacteria is a really natural part of our bodies. In fact, strip us away from everything, we are bacteria underneath. So an example is vitamin C. Without vitamin C, you can get things like scurvy. We know from research years ago how the sailors used to get scurvy. And it's such a simple thing, yet it's coming back today where children just aren't eating the fruits and vegetables. When I go through most people's diets, I can clearly see there's a lack of vegetables in those diets. Clearly see that. And that needs to change. I sat in on a doctor surgery once where I just sat in and listened, and the doctor told me that there were 12 cases a day of type 2 diabetes, 12 a day. He said it's just growing and growing and growing. And I think people need to realise that it's preventable. We don't have to have type 2 diabetes. And what's more, once you get it, you can reverse it. Despite, contrary to what people are saying, you can reverse it. This is about eating food in its most natural state. The unbelievable results that people can get, and the feedback that I get, is absolutely second to none. And so it's important to remember that we only have one life, and we need to look after and support ourselves and support our bodies. We need to be aware every single day, because no one's going to pick up the pieces here. No one's going to start picking up the pieces. The NHS is doing the very best that it can, but unfortunately it's not going to be able to keep going, and we have to question whether it will be here forever. We truly have to do that. And so we need to start with ourselves and with our families. That's where we need to go. And I'm quite passionate about the fact that we really do need to do that.